Hi friends, welcome back to this React.js advanced concept series. In the last video, I have explained about use imperative handle hook. In this video, I'm going to talk about use layout effect in depth. Let's start. What is use layout effect? Use layout effect is a React hook that allows us to perform side effects after all DOM mutations have been applied. This is different from use effect. Let me show you the comparison. useEffect hook performs side effects after the render is painted to the screen. But this useLayoutEffect hook runs after the DOM updates but before the screen is painted. useEffect fires asynchronously, but this useLayoutEffect hook fires synchronously. Okay, let me show you an example so that you can understand this clearly. In this component, I have a div with a fixed width of 400 pixels. I am using an useRef to access this div element. And I'm having a text content state which is initialized to initial text. Also, I'm using an useEffect to check the width of the div and update this text content if its width is greater than 300 pixels. And so we can see this. But if I refresh, we can see the initial text first and then the updated text. Let me show you in slow motion. So this is creating a flickering effect. Let's see how this is going to be when we use useLayoutEffect instead of useEffect. Now we are not seeing the flickering effect because this useLayoutEffect hook runs before the initial text has painted on the screen. Hope you understood the difference. So useLayoutEffect in React is particularly useful in scenarios where you need to perform DOM related operations that must be completed before the browser paints. For example, if our component needs to measure its position or dimensions and the results are needed to make immediate adjustments to the other elements, useLayoutEffect is ideal. Using this, we can avoid flickering effect or layout shifts. Sometimes a state update may depend on information from the DOM, such as user scroll position, and must be consistent before screen updates. Here, useLayoutEffect guarantees the state change happens in sync with rendering. Also, sometimes we may need to modify an element, such as focusing an input as soon as it mounts and before the user interacts with it. useLayoutEffect ensures the change is applied immediately and it is more appropriate than useEffect. Because the input will be focused before the page is painted, ensuring a smooth and predictable user experience. Sometimes state changes or effects may cause layout changes. Using useEffect can lead to layout shifts if the state update happens after the browser has already painted a frame. With useLayoutEffect, we can ensure such changes are synchronized with rendering to avoid these issues. For scenarios where we need to reset or undo DOM manipulations, for example, if we need to clear or reset content based on some condition, we can use useLayoutEffect before the visual output is rendered. While useLayoutEffect is useful in the scenarios above, it should be used sparingly. Since it blocks painting, overuse can lead to performance bottlenecks. In cases where we don't need to interact with the DOM immediately or synchronously, prefer using useEffect to avoid unnecessary render blocking. Hope you understood. That's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe and comment below with any questions or future topics you'd like to see. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.